High Jazz Band. Aren't they fantastic? Will you all please rise for the presentation of colors by the Hamilton High School Air Force Junior ROTC and remain standing while the Basha High School Choir performs the national anthem. Hamilton High School ROTC is under the direction of Lieutenant Colonel Greg Franklin and Master Sergeant Fred Driver. And what talented vocalists we have in the Basha High School Choir. Robin Badalik oversees the choral program at Basha High School. And by the way, they're headed to Carnegie Hall next week in New York City. Can you see why? One more round of applause for all these students. Well, good evening. I'm Terry Locke, and I want to welcome everyone to the District Night of Special Recognition. Assisting tonight will be our governing board, and it's my pleasure to introduce all of them at this time, beginning with our president, Annette Oxier. Come on up, Annette. Vice President Barb Mosden. David Evans. Karen McGee. And Bob Rice. You all know our superintendent, Dr. Camille Casteel. Also assisting at the stairway tonight, our assistant superintendents, Matt Strom, Sandy Cooper, and Frank Fletcher. We've asked our board president, Annette Oxier, to share a few words before we get started tonight.
We're so thrilled to be here with you to help you celebrate your excellence. About 2008, 2009, that kind of time frame, we were doing really well as a district, and we decided to see that we could do even better. So we had the confidence to move forward with a plan that we called Journey 2020, and it's a rigorous plan to help us be better in every arena, sports, athletics, choral, band, robotics, and shall we not forget, academics. And we have moved forward so well the last 2 years, and I know you're going to want to applaud this. We've been named the number one school district in the state. So we thank you for your contribution to helping us along that way of being the number one school district in the state. But our poor superintendent, you've got to have pity on her, because we have not let off our foot from the pedal. We have asked her to be the number one school district in the United States. And can we do it? Yes, we can. Welcome.
Thank you, Annette. This is exciting tonight. Here's what we're going to do. The program looks really big, but we have a way to get through this. What we're going to do is in the order of the program, from start to finish, we're going to ask the recipient to come up and the next recipient on the program to go to the on-deck circle where Jeff LeBenz. Jeff, would you wave or do a somersault? He's going to have the next person. That's kind of our on-deck circle tonight. You're going to see how it goes after about two or three. We're going to show them live. Mm-hmm. Without further ado, I would like to ask Donnie Baranowski from Knox Gifted Academy to join the board on stage. Come on up. And Dustin Phillips, you're going to be next. So go to the on-deck circle, Dustin, if you would. So we begin tonight's event by recognizing a student who promoted peace through work of art. Donnie's a sixth grader at Knox Gifted Academy, and he won the regional award in the Sun Lakes Lions Club International Peace Poster Contest. We'd like to show you his poster tonight, but has gone on to compete at the state and perhaps international level. Congratulations, Donnie, for winning, and good luck at the next level of competition. Okay, next up is Dustin Phillips and Benjamin Leroy. You will be next. Now, in addition to being a top senior at Basha High School, Dustin was named Arizona's Top Youth Volunteer of 2016 by the Prudential Spirit of Community Award. Dustin's in volunteer activities, Dustin's Kids Helping Kids, expanded significantly 3 years ago when he formed a chapter at his high school. And altogether, more than 200 young people in three states now participate in projects organized by Dustin and fellow Basha High students. And next month, he's going to be recognized with an all-expense-paid trip to Washington, D.C., where he'll receive $1,000 and an engraved medallion. Next is Benjamin Leroy, also from Basha High School. And Chandler High, FFA, you will be next. So Benjamin Leroy was named a candidate in the 2016 United States Presidential Scholars Program. His candidacy is based on an outstanding academic performance on his ACT assessment and College Board SAT. Now, of nearly 3.3 million high school seniors graduating this year, he's one of approximately 4,000 nationally to make this to get this invitation. So, Benjamin, congratulations, and don't go too far tonight because we're going to call you back up for the Science Award in a little bit. Okay, now we have on stage the Future Farmers of America team from Chandler High School, and Basha FFA, naturally, will be next. So this year, Chandler High School FFA placed fifth in the nation in the Novice Parliamentary Procedure Competition in Louisville, Kentucky. Now out of this group, Faith Everett and Dayton Larson also earned perfect scores on their multiple choice tests, where the questions are from parliamentarian certification tests. Students also had to perform a parliamentary procedure demonstration for 10 minutes. Now, students did not know the topic or the required motions for this, so very impressive, and congratulations to Chandler High FFA. Staying on the same topic, the Future Farmers of America from Basha High School team, please come up, and the Hamilton Academic Decathlon team is on deck. Now, we have two state champions to recognize from Basha High School. In the category of State Floriculture Career Development Event, the team of Jacob Ariaza, Sydney Kello, Marcelo Rodarte, and Madison Tursky, they won a competition designed to promote the study of and interest in production and retailing of flowers, plants, and foliage through the Agricultural Education Program. Our other champions are in the category of State Nursery Landscape Career Development Event, designed to promote the study and interest of all aspects of the plant nursery. Our state winning team students are Jacob Ariaza, Madison Montez, Marcelo Rodarte, and Madison Tursky. Both of these teams will be competing at the National FFA Convention in Indianapolis. Congratulations. All right, let's bring up the Academic Decathlon team from Hamilton High School. Basha High School FCCLA team will be next. Now, the United States Academic Decathlon is a 10-event scholarship competition. It includes math, economics, literature, music, art, science, history, speech, interview, and essay. And every year, students in the program study material centered on a theme. The theme for the 2015-16 Academic Decathlon was India. Hamilton High not only won Region 4, which historically is the most competitive region in Arizona, but went on to earn a spot at the national competition by finishing as the Arizona Academic Decathlon state runners-up. Good luck. Next is the Basha High FCCLA team, and next will be Hamilton Debate. So Basha High School went to the Family Career and Community Leaders of America State Competition in Tucson, and all 14 competitors received medals. The following students placed first or second in the state and will represent Arizona in their competitive event at the FCCLA of America Nationals this summer. Karen Haven, Mason Macron, Mia Moylan, Kennedy Schneeberger, Sarah Maurer, Cami Frotnick, Riley Williams, Caitlin Pratt, Bella Plum, and Emily Richens. Additionally, teacher Melanie Alexander received the Arizona Family Career and Community Leaders of America Spirit of Advising Award and will be recognized at the Nationals this year as well. I was remiss in introducing Joel Wirth. He's our CFO, and he keeps us on track financially. Joel, we appreciate you being here tonight. The Hamilton High School debate team and then Payne Junior High Aerospace program will be next. Now, Hamilton's debate team advanced to the Sweet 16 round of the Global Debate Competition. Now, hundreds of debate teams from around the world entered the 15-16 International Public Policy Forum competition, but only 16 remained in the competition, including a team from Hamilton High. Now, last July, more than 200 teams from around the world competed in written debates about the use of GMOs, or genetically modified organisms. This group from Hamilton made it to the Sweet 16 internationally, and we're so proud of them. Okay, next we have the Payne Junior High School Aerospace team, and the ICEF and ASEF winners, you're going to be next. So get ready. We got a good team of you. Regarding Payne Junior High Aerospace, the following students were recognized during this year's Aerospace Design Challenge that was sponsored by Honeywell, winning judges' choice out of more than 50 teams from across the state of Arizona for most livable base was the Avion, and Anna Curry, Alex Curtis, Hannah Doyle, Colleen Robinson, Roman Valenzuela, and the winning judge's choice for best secondary mission, which was Team Delta Verities, was Joshua Hansen, Hannah Horn, Spencer Sigworth, Janet Thampy, Andrew Zimmerman. Congratulations to the Payne Junior High School team. All right, let's get that army of great science kids coming to the stage. This is awesome. Come on up. We'll do the ASEF and ISEF and Knox Gifted Academy. And then Carrie and Sienna from Perry High School will be on the on-deck circle next. Now, once again, CUSD schools dominated in the Arizona Science and Engineering Fair in Phoenix earlier this month. Now, out of the 15 projects in Arizona that qualified for the International Science and Engineering Fair, 10 of those 15 hailed from Chandler Unified. Now, give you some perspective. Chandler Unified educates 3% of the state population, and we had 67% of the winners going on to international. Isn't that amazing? Hamilton High School is the senior division school winner for the third year in a row, and congratulations to the following winners. Eight projects advancing to ISEP from Hamilton include Arisop Nijat, Rikita Bharati, Sakan Konan, Vidak Naval, Zengdong Wang, Rahul Ramesh, Akshata Radhapatna, I hope, Kara Blonde, Komal Agarwal. Now, from Arizona College Prep Erie, we have McKenna Loop, also advancing to international. And advancing from Basha High School, Michael Curry and Benjamin Leroy, who we met earlier from Basha High School. They're all going on to represent Chandler Unified in Arizona in the International Science and Engineering Fair. Let's get the Knox kids up here, too. We didn't have room on the stage for all the science winners. That's how well they did this year. Knox just keeps knocking it out of the park. They were recently named a number one elementary school in Arizona by one of the ratings, which is fantastic. And the reason for that is because they're accomplishing so doggone much. And here's the latest one. Out of all the schools in Arizona, they were ranked as the elementary division champions at the Arizona Science and Engineering Fair. Isn't that amazing? Congratulations, kids. Keep going in junior high and high school. Now let's have Carrie Earnhardt and Sienna Samura from Perry High School come forward. And Eric Nakamoto, you'll be next. Okay, for the third year in a row, Perry High School has two All-American marching band students, Carrie Earnhardt on the tuba and Sienna Samore on the clarinet. They received an all-expenses-paid trip to San Antonio, Texas to perform at the halftime show of this year's 2016 All-American Bowl. There were only eight students selected from Arizona this year and two from Perry High School here in Chandler Unified. Congratulations, Carrie and Sienna. Next, let's have Eric Nakamoto to the stage, and the Willis Junior High Band will be next. Eric is a junior at Hamilton High School, and he performed with the 2016 Honor Orchestra of America at Music for All National Festival concerts alongside the Indianapolis Symphony Orchestra in Indianapolis the weekend of March 9th through the 12th. He had quite a spring break, didn't he? Nakamoto plays bass with the Hamilton High School Chamber Orchestra, Jazz Ensemble, and in the Pit Orchestra for the school's theater productions. In addition, he was selected in January as the bass player for the All-State Jazz Band, effectively naming him as the best high school jazz bass player in Arizona. Speaking of all that jazz, next we have the Willis High School Jazz Band coming to the stage, and Kara Lindner will be next. The Willis Junior High School Jazz Band, under the direction of John Stadzinski, was selected to perform at the Jazz Education Network, or GEN Conference, in Louisville, Kentucky, at the Galt House Convention Center back in January. Founded in Chicago in 2008, this is the largest and annual international jazz conference. Now, Willis Junior High School's Jazz Band was the only junior high school selected to perform at this event. The students are intensely focused on teamwork, musicianship, and preparation in order to assure another great performance. Thank you, everybody. Congratulations. Next, I'd like to ask Kara Linder to come to the stage, and our two great swimmers, Mark Jurek and Ty Dang, you're next. Now, Kara attends both Chandler Online Academy and Hamilton High School, and she won first place for the second year in a row in the Cadet Sabre World Cup Fencing Championship. She's also the only fencer to ever win back-to-back in the history of the event. Kara is also one of only three female Americans to win. She also placed seventh at the Junior World Cup in Udine, Italy, which made her the highest-placing American fencer. Congratulations, Kara, and thanks for representing Chandler. Okay, next, Mark Jurek and Ty Dang. Truman Park, you're going to be next. This is not the first time we've invited Mark to join us on stage. He's now a senior at Chandler High, and this year he captured his fifth and sixth state titles in 3 years. Mark won the 200-yard freestyle and the 200-yard individual medley back in November. Also named the male swimmer of the year, so you've left quite a legacy at Chandler High School. Now, Ty Dang is the current state champion in the boys' 100 breaststroke, and he's a senior at Hamilton High School. And Ty, listen to this, qualified for the Olympic trials just 3 weeks ago in the 200-meter breast and will attend West Point next fall. Next, we have the Hamilton High and Chandler High Online Academy Junior Truman Park. Come on up to the stage. I should say come up to the putting green. And let's go ahead and have Ellie come onto the on-deck circle. We're going to share a story with you this is right out of Hollywood. So playing in the state championship round at the Gila Golf Course in Levine, Truman rallied for a two-stroke deficit with one hole to play. This is the state championship, right? He needed a par and a birdie to help force a third hole tiebreaker, where Truman won the individual championship by chipping in for an eagle. Seriously. He's the sixth player to win a state championship in the last 10 years at Hamilton. And a great job, Truman. Now I'd like to ask Ellie Millen, and Rena Han couldn't be here. She's traveling to China to accept a scholarship and can't make it. Santan Cheer, you're going to be next, by the way. Well, anyway, Ellie here and her partner Rena both attend Hamilton, and they won the 5A Division I Badminton State Doubles Championship. The girls' title came down to an all-CUSD battle between Perry's Lakey Reader and Lauren Cater and versus these two ladies, and Ellie and Rena prevailed 15-10, 15-7 in the championship, capping a sensational season in which they only lost one set. Congratulations. All right, we've got the cheerleaders from Santan Junior High coming to the stage. Hamilton Cheer, naturally, you're going to be next. So this team traveled to California to compete nationally and ended up also coming in second place in the nation. These guys were second in the nation competing in California. The team competed five times in state against other junior highs from all over Arizona. They ended their season undefeated and won the state championship title. They went on to the national competition in California. As I mentioned, they were the national runners up. And congratulations, girls, for another incredible year. So speaking of cheerleaders, let's have the Hamilton High School squad come to the stage. Hamilton Dance will be next. So this year's 2016 Hamilton cheer team was full of inspired and committed young women and men. And because of their hard work, Hamilton received their ninth Arizona state title and their first overall AIA co-ed division title. Now that includes cheer, palm, and partner stunt scores. So that's their first overall co-ed division title in the 18-year history of the school. So way to represent Hamilton High and CUSD. Yeah. There's plenty of talent in the pipeline. You got Santan Junior High. A lot of those kids are going to be feeding into Hamilton. Their program will be strong for a long time, won't it? Now can I have the Hamilton Dance Company come to the stage with Hamilton Girls Basketball? Next. Dance Company's not here? Oh, they are here. Good. You got it. Is Girls Basketball here? Next. They're on deck. Yep. Good. Yeah, let's show all this off. This is awesome. We got one more. This is great. The Hamilton Dance Company, state champions in jazz and hip-hop, and placed fifth place hip-hop USA Nationals. Hamilton Dance Company competed at the 30th annual Arizona State Cheerleading and Pom Competition in March, defending their title as state champions in the jazz division. At the competition held at the Arizona Memorial Coliseum, the dance team won first in the jazz and hip-hop divisions. Congratulations. Now let's have Coach Trevor Nieder and the girls' Hamilton High School basketball team join us on stage. Hamilton boys soccer, you will be next. Okay, these ladies, coached by Trevor Nieder, won the Division I state basketball championships this year. This was Hamilton's first ever basketball title, boys or girls. The Huskies entered the tournament as the number 3 seed, but pulled off 2 upsets to bring home the trophy. First, they defeated Valley Vista in the semifinals at Grand Canyon University, and then beat Mesquite 56-46 in the championship game in Glendale. Great season, Hamilton High Huskies. Next, I'm going to have the Hamilton High boys soccer team come on stage. I don't believe the Chandler girls cross country team could be there at the city meet. All right, let's look at the Hamilton boys soccer team. The team won their first ever championship title this year. I'm back to the other, I'm sorry, the Chandler High thing, not here. The Hamilton High boys soccer team won the state championship at Camp Olindo High School. They scored 2 goals in the final 9 minutes for an exciting come from behind 2-1 victory over Gilbert. The Huskies, under the direction of Coach Nick Marquette, played in their 5th title game in 7 years. And a big congratulations, guys. I don't believe the Chandler High School girls cross country team here. We're having an all-city track meet today, and they're all pretty much involved in that, so we'll find a different way to recognize them. That concludes the student segment of our recognition program. At this time, we would like to start recognizing our adults, starting with a group of volunteers and some of our fabulous staff. At this time, I want to ask that all the Art Masterpiece volunteer coordinators please come to the stage. These are the unsung heroes that are operating our Art Masterpiece program in our elementary schools. CUSD's Art Masterpiece program depends on our volunteers. At each elementary school site, there is one person or sometimes a small team who have agreed to act as their school's Art Masterpiece coordinator. These dedicated people spend hours working to find classroom volunteers for their school. They keep track of their school's inventory of art supplies, and they're the first point of contact for their school's art guides who have questions, comments, or requests. Now, without these committed volunteers, it'd be difficult to keep the Art Masterpiece program at each school site running effectively. The CUSD Art Masterpiece program is very grateful to our hardworking school coordinators for the many hours they spend in service to the district's youngest students. We want to recognize in front of the audience tonight Debbie St. Pierre, Patricia Shady, Jen Colburn, Yvonne Colland, Carla Tandon, Vicki Kinsella, Kristen Elam, Heather Catlin, Cheryl Fogelman, Harami Yampal, Noemi Isaacson, Melissa Jensen, Kristen Boyd, Tavia Olive, Heidi Leff, and Adrian Honeycutt. Thank you for all you continue to do. For the final segment of our ceremony, we would like to recognize staff members of their personal achievements this year. So I'm gonna start by asking the Si Se Puede award winners to come to the stage at this time. Then after we recognize Si Se Puede, we'll have Jennifer Wurzel on deck. Okay, next is our Cesar Chavez Si Se Puede Award winners. Jennifer Wurzel is ready next. Si Se Puede honored three educators from Chandler Unified at the 16th Annual Cesar Chavez Recognition and Awards Dinner this month. Violet Nelson, on your far right, counselor at Chandler High School, has a heart for students. She takes the time to get to know the students as more than just students, but as human beings who have great potential. She's a tremendous resource to her students and is always able to secure the information that students are seeking. Jeff Delp is the principal at Willis Junior High School and a person of the highest personal and professional integrity. Jeff is relentless in his personal commitment to learning and making an impact. A visionary leader, Jeff identifies the ideal state for the groups he guides and allowing those beliefs to drive his day-to-day actions and decisions. A lot of great things happening at Willis. And Chris Newen, the music teacher at Hartford Sylvia Encinas Elementary, outstanding educator who makes great connections with staff and students alike. Chris works tirelessly with the Desert Sounds nonprofit group to secure instruments for students who would otherwise not have the opportunity to participate in band or orchestra. Congratulations to our 2016 Si Se Puede Award winners. Thank you for all your dedication. Okay, next we have Jennifer Wurzel from Basha High School. And Sarah Wifels will be next. Now, Jennifer was nominated as the Arizona Language Association Teacher of the Year for the state of Arizona for 2015-16. A Spanish language teacher, Jennifer will represent the state at the regional level. We want to say congratulations, Senora Wurzel. Another senora, another Spanish language teacher, Sarah Wifels is coming up. Lauren Delfina Carl will be next. Sarah is also a Spanish teacher working with students at Chandler High School. And this year she was selected by the Arizona International Baccalaureate School Organization as the Teacher of the Year. Criteria include a distinguished teacher performance, fidelity to international baccalaureate principles and practices, and service as a mentor and supporter to other international baccalaureate teachers. Congratulations, Sarah. Now I'd like to invite on stage second grade teacher, San Marcos Elementary's Lauren Delfino Carl. Mike McKelvey is next. Lauren was named a 2016 Rodel Exemplary Teacher. She's one of 15 educators across the state to be recognized by Rodel. Lauren Delfino Carl is a dynamic educator. Her students always make great gains and enjoying learning in her classroom. She's also a mentor and role model to other teachers on campus, and we're so fortunate to have you. Wow. All right, Mike McKelvey from Basha High School. Mike has been selected as a state finalist for the Presidential Award for Excellence in Mathematics and Science Teaching. This qualifies him for the national competition. A national selection committee reviews the state finalist applications and makes recommendations, which are forwarded to the White House. The President of the United States will announce the national recipients by the summer of 2017. Congratulations, Michael, for being selected for this prestigious award. And last but not least, we'd like to recognize our Rocky Mountain Emmy Award winners. We have Tim Wong. Please come to the stage. Tim's been working tonight. Michael Holland is in Tennessee, and he can't join us. But let me tell you, these two were honored for their work on a documentary called The History of Chandler Schools, Part 3, Summary of a Century. Tim Wong is a Chandler High School graduate and current staff member. He won in the category of Graphic Arts and Art Direction. CUSD was the only K-12 district competing for an Emmy in an arena dominated by commercial television news and public broadcasting media. CUSD was a finalist for 6 awards again this year, so it was another fantastic year. We got through that pretty quickly, didn't we? That's going to conclude the program, but we'd like you to stick around in the lobby. We've got refreshments in the foyer. Students and parents, feel free to take balloons with you, take them home, and continue the celebration at home. And we appreciate you joining us tonight. Thank you for being here, and thank you for choosing Chandler Unified School District.